morning everyone, hope you all safe with a good health. With you Ms. Dina Albadi, physics teacher for grade 12. Today we'll complete our lesson current and circuit. Today we'll talk about resistance and Ohm's law. Suppose two conductors have a potential difference between them. If they are connected with a copper rods, a large current is created. On the other hand, putting a glass rod between them creates almost no current. The property determining how much current will flow is called resistance. Resistance is measured by placing a potential difference across a conductor and dividing the voltage by the current. The resistance, R, is defined as the ratio of the electric potential difference to the current, I. So R equal V divided I. So it is the resistance in the Ohm's law, R equal V divided I. Resistance is equal to the voltage divided by the current. The resistance of the conductor is measured in ohms. 1 ohm is the resistance permitting an electric charge of 1 ampere to flow when a potential difference of 1 volt is applied across the resistance. A simple circuit relating resistance, current and voltage shown in the figure. Because wires have so little resistance, there is almost no potential drop across them. To produce greater potential drops, a large resistance concentrated into a small volume is necessary. A resistor is a device designed to have a specific resistance. So what is the resistor? Is a device designed to have a specific resistance. Resistors may be made of graphite, semiconductors or wires that are long and thin. There are two ways to control the current in the circuit. What are the two ways to control a current in the circuit? Because I equal V divided R, I can be changed by varying V or R or both of them. The figure A shows a simple circuit. When V is 6 volt and R is 30 ohm, the current is 0.2 ampere. How could the current be reduced to 0.1 ampere? According to Ohm's law, the greater the voltage placed across the resistors, the larger the current passing through it. So when we increase the voltage placed across the resistor, so we will increase the amount of current passing through it. If the current through a resistor is cut in half, the potential difference also cut in half. Here in the first figure, the voltage applied across the resistors is reduced from 6 volt to 3 volt to reduce the current to 0.1 ampere. A second way to reduce the current to 0.1 ampere is to replace the resistor, 30 ohm, with the 60 ohm, as shown in the figure. So, if you want to decrease the amount of current, we will decrease the amount of potential difference, or increase the resistance, okay? Resistors often are used to control the current in the circuit of or parts of the circuit. Sometimes a smooth continuous variation of the current is desired. For example, the speed control on the some electric motors allow continuous rather than step-by-step change in the rotation of the motor. To achieve the kind of the control of, we called it a potentiometer. The human body acts as a variable resistors. When dry skin, resistance is high enough to keep currents that are produced by small and moderate voltage low. If the skin becomes wet, its resistance is lower and the electric current can rise to dangerous level. A current as low as 1 milliampere can be felt as a mild shock, while currents of 15 milliampere can cause the loss of muscles control, and currents of 100 milliampere can cause this. So, if we have 30 voltage battery is connected to 10 ohms resistor. What is the current in the circuit? According to this law, we have V and R, and the unknown part is I, the electric current. I equal V divided R, so the answer it will be 30 divided 10, it will be 3 ampere. Okay, that's all. Hope you all understand. Please check LMS and print the sheet. Goodbye.